Hello guys, testing testing 1 2 3. Can you guys hear me? Sorry for technical problem just now. Alright. So currently we have 25 viewers. So I bet we are all good to go for the lunch learning session. So technical problem just now. So for you guys that do not know me, my name is Muhammad Ikram bin Abdul Rahim. I'm based at Shah Alam as product and project engineer. So my portfolio here at Tekom basically handling most of the API CA product. And for today, I will be sharing on the basic introduction of ChopWAF, which is which we have joint venture with our principal from UK, Inline WAF. So, okay. All right.
Betul.
Tak nak tunjuk. Slide tak nak, tak nak keluar. Kau remove, add kan balik. Oh. Sorry for the technical problem. So I will proceed with my sharing session today. So on summary, I will be sharing on the definition. On the second, I will be sharing a little bit on application of chokes that we have in our industry. And the third one, what type of design that we have and what type of design that we can offer that have in the market. And the fourth is the actuation and control. So what is choke valve? As you can see in the picture, it is an angle valve. So inlet is coming from the side and outlet is opposite side of the handwheel. And we have our trim in the middle, colored as orange one. So what is a choke? As it name, so a choke is actually a design restriction in a flow line. So it can be fixed or it can be variable in order for us to provide control of the fluid flow coming from the well. So a choke is a control valve that control our flow by inducing pressure drop. So why do the choke valve we have it as angle valve? It is because by changing the angle of the flow, so it can reduce the pressure. So that is why the reason behind of the angle valve lah for the choke. So moving on to the next slide. So what type of application that we will be using choke in our oil and gas industry? So for the first type is production well. So as you can see in the photo beside, you can see that we have a lot of gate valve such as master valve, kill wing valve and sweat valve at the Christmas tree. And at the tip of the Christmas tree, we will be having a surface choke. So the surface choke will be used to control the flow rate coming from the well prior we send our production to the separation at the downstream. On the second type of application, choke also will be used in artificial lift, either for the water injection and also for the gas injection. So artificial lift is normally will be applied whenever our production has been depleted for over 20 or 30 years upon first production. So it cannot be produced by its natural pressure difference. So we will be needing this kind of artificial lift. And then choke also is used to regulate the flow of the water and also of the gas to control the flow into the well. And the third type of application is Choke also will be used during well testing activity. So at this stage, during the well testing, choke is to be connected direct with the wellhead without the Christmas tree. For this type of application of well test, so usually operators will be using the choke and kill manifold in order to regulate the flow coming from the well prior they send our production to flare. And regarding the standards for the choke valve, it's governed under APICA. And on the specification level, we can provide from PSL1 until PSL4. And for the PR, which is the design validation, so the valve itself need to undergo performance requirement 1 and 2. So for the PR1, it need to comply and achieve the standard mechanical properties, chemical composition, and it need to go through the hydro test. But for the PR2, it will be required to have an additional high cycle test at low temperature, at normal temperature, and also at a very high temperature. It is quite equivalent with the TAT. But for the choke valve, we will not require to do the TAT, but only PR2 is required. Right, moving on to the next slide. So basically, these are the choke trim type evolution. At first, operators only use the fixed beam or positive beam. We can call it as fixed choke or positive choke. Both are the same. And the further improvement, they have improved into the needle and seat choke. So for this needle and seat, they can regulate the flow. And the next is this MOV, which is a multi orifice valve. And for the lower part of the slide, you can see the external sleeve, plug and cage, and multi stage. So this kind of trim is considered as cage type. So these three are most likely to be used in our current market. And then on the next slide, so what is positive choke and why it is being called as fixed beam? So positive choke is only to be used in order to cater fixed CV and flow rate. As you can see in the slide, it has the beam, which is the red colored one. So for the positive choke, we cannot control the flow rate. So it is designed for its specific CV and flow rate only. So whenever the operation team want to increase or to regulate the flow, so they need to disassemble and change the beam size. On the prior rating itself, we can provide from 2000 up until 15,000 for API. And for the ANSI class, we can supply up to 4,500 pound rating. And for the positive choke, it can be converted into adjustable one by we will be needing to disassemble the choke and then to modify the trim to needle and seat. So for the flange end, it will be available for both API and RC type. It depends on the requirement from client. So for this positive choke, it is famous to be used in choke and kill manifold, well testing and cleanup operation. Right, moving on to the next, which is the needle and seat. So this kind of choke is further improvement from the positive choke. So as you can see in the photo, so the design is quite equivalent with the fixed choke. Just that it has the stem needle assembly and also it has the hand wheel in order for us to control the flow rate. So it is also compatible if, let's say, the operation want to fix the flow rate, it is also compatible to fix means choke. Alright, moving on to the plug and cage, which is the cage guided type. For the PC type of choke, it will be using a plug inside a cage. So the plug, as you can see in the photo, will be colored as orange one. So it will be moved downward and upward in order to open and close the valve. So it is called as internally guided because the trim itself move inside the cage. The plug itself move inside the cage. So why do we need to have internally guided design? It is because in order for us to control the vibration due to the high flow, due to the high flow rate coming from the well. So it helps in cater the high vibration due to the flow. So this type of plug and cage choke valve, it is a metal shut off. So we can offer class 4 and class 5. So please be reminded that choke valve is control valve. So it has a certain allowable leakage that we need to consider. So that's why we only offer class 5 and class 4. So moving on to the next slide, which is the external sleeve. It's basically quite the same with PC. So for this one, it is not internally guided, it is externally guided because the sleeve itself is moving externally outside the cage. So that is why it is called as externally guided. So for the flow characteristic, we can offer both linear and also equal percentage. And the theory for the ES type of choke, so the flow coming from the inlet will enter the holes, the port, if, as you can see in the photo, and then the flow particles will collide and dissipate energy by the collision by each other. So on the rating and classes is quite the same with PC, and on the class leakage shut off also quite the same. It's just that for the ES type of trim, it will be possible, it will be preferable for high production gas well. It is because due to the nature of the gas, it is lighter if compared to the liquid, right? So for the gas, so that if you can see in the photo, high flow rate of the gas will come in through the ports. So the flow tends to go at the upper position of the inner sleeve. But for the liquid, it will be better for us to use the PC type of cage, PC type of choke, sorry. So this a summary for the cage type of trim. So we have PC and also we have ES type of trim. So for the PC, it will be able to cater maximum flow capacity, but for low DP, it is mainly to be used at oil production and water injection, but it is less suitable for low pressure gas production and injection. But for the external sleeve, it will be better in catering maximum erosion and for the high pressure gas production. It was due to the larger surface area in the inner trim of the sleeve. So moving on to the next slide, which is also considered as case guided. So this one is more special because it is to better the high pressure differential and mostly been used in water injector well. So it can be two or three layers. It depends on the pressure drop that we have. So for this one, due to the nature of the water properties, so usually operators will be using the water coming from the well. So it is usually having the chemicals that can corrode our internal part of the choke. So we can offer stellated seat, seat ring and also for the plug. So this is the sample of the CC LN2. It has double layer of the cage in order to cater for the high DP. So the small hole is designed in order to split the flow stream. So flow coming from the well will be separated and splitted through the small hole, and then in order for the flow to dissipate their energy, and then we can cater the high vibration. All right. So moving on to the next slide, which is the multi-stage energy dissipating type of trim. So for this multi-stage ED type of trim, it is designed to cater even extreme pressure differential. So for the previous CC trim, it only able to cater up to 4 stage. But for the ED, it can be designed to drop the pressure up until 6 stage. It is less likely to be found in our market right now, but it is usually being used in water dumping application. So how does the ED type of trim cater with the high DP? So as you can see in the photo, flow coming from the upstream will enter the tortuous path of the disc. So by changing the direction, the flow particles will collide between each other, and then we convert the high kinetic energy into heat energy. So it is able to cater with the high noise and also high vibration. So for this graph, we can see that the multi-stage is able to drop the pressure up until 6 stage, starting from the inlet pressure P1, 2600 PSI, up, and then the pressure is dropped until 150. Right, so based on my previous explanation on each type of the choke valve, so there is no one solution in order for us to cater for all process data. But basically on our design, you need to pay attention to the pressure drop. As I mentioned, is that high pressure drop will lead to cavitation. So we have our own solution such as the CC trim and also for the ED type of trim. And also for the velocity, which can cause erosion and also vibration to the trim. So we need to ensure that before we confirm on the design, we have taken into consideration on the vibration, the velocity of the fluid coming and out of the choke valve, so that it can erode the internal part of the trim. And for the sound, generally, it need to be designed so that it only have maximum of 85 decibel. On the material side, So for the choke valve, because it needs to cater the raw production coming from the well. So usually for the oil production well, it has a lot of sand. So our solution is to propose the solid tungsten carbide to cater with the high sand, and the cobalt alloy and stellite usually is to cater with the corrosion issue. So we can offer Inconel to be well overlay to the trim, and also we can offer the exotic materials such as duplet and super duplet materials. So just now I have explained on the basic type of the valve, starting from the positive choke and the control choke such as the needle and seat, and the control choke, and then the cage type of choke valve such as the plug and cage, and also the external sleeve. And for even higher pressure drop, so we have our own solution such as CC trim and also ED trim. So on the actuation side, on the actuation type is now, so we can offer manual and we can offer actuated type of choke. So the for the manual, we can offer regular hand wheel. It depends on the client preference. And for the actuated type, we can offer electric, MOV, and what on the pneumatic side, we can offer pneumatic stepping, linear type, which is by utilizing piston and diaphragm. And on the mounting side, it depends on the client restriction to assemble at site. It can be direct and it also can be angle mount. For the hydraulic, we can also offer hydraulic stepping and hydraulic near type by utilizing the piston, the single acting. So this is the sample of motorized choke valve that Inline has supplied to Middle East, to one of the onshore well. So this photo shown on the pneumatic linear actuator. On the left side is for the single acting actuator, and on the right side for the pneumatic diaphragm. So this photo show on our previous project, which was done, I bet, on 2015. This choke valve has been assembled at our workshop at Shah Alam. So this is the rotary stepping hydraulic actuator. So this is the actual photo for the hydraulic, which is on the right side, and on the pneumatic rotary stepping on the left side. And this is the sample of the rotary stepping hydraulic. And this photo shown the hydraulic actuator for the choke valve. So we can also offer FF, foundation field bus, the heart control, and analog protocol. So I bet this is the end of my presentation. So before I end, I have a quiz to be shared to all of you. So the winner is that to the one that answered the first will be considered as winner. The question is like this. So I will screenshot to the winner that answered the first, and then we will contact the winner lah on the present. Alright. Oh, seems you guys got what I have said today. So it's good lah. You guys understand? Right. A lot of answer. Okay, guys, I bet this is the end of my presentation. Thanks to all for your time, and hopefully you can benefit from my sharing. So anything regarding Chopwaf, you can hit me up and contact me. So thanks. See you soon. Nanti apa? Let's play. Habis ni.